It felt Piper. It's Piper right here. Sun is starting to get in from that window. It's hitting me in my face. Hoping this video finds you well. Get closer to the camera, maybe. Move this side. I'm trying to fix something today, but first, enjoying some early morning match the sunrise from Südlift. Got a tin on November of 2021, so it's more than a year that I've had this blend. I have both the match and the early morning pipe, Peterson's. They taste the same. I can hardly notice the difference between one and the other. It is one of my favorite blends, either one. I mean, Peterson or the match. Love them both. And I haven't smoked that one for 6 months or so. What I did is, you know, suddenly if you buy it in bulk, I bought, I think it's 2 ounces, and put it in this jar and with the espresso coffee tamper, that is a big circle, just press it down as much as I can and let it sit there. So yeah, you know, it has a strong flavor. Really good. And I'm using the Savinelli 2021 at Christmas 2021 edition, 673. Good. About that time, I bought this from Tobacco Pipes. Pipes and Tobacco, sorry. It's Cobblestone, I think, and the brand. And it's a very good lighter. Works perfect. The only bummer thing is that maybe 4 months after I bought it and start using it, I noticed that the fuel would evaporate quicker than it used to be, and used to do it at the beginning. So I start, you know, kind of wondering what's going on with this lighter. And I notice that, you know, the little valve where the gas comes out, when you close the cap, kind of, well, the gas, the butane still leaks a little bit. And you notice, because the intensity of the flame goes down, I just feel it, like, I don't know, 10 seconds of butane, 10 second count. That would normally last me for, if I use it on a daily basis, probably a week. And suddenly a day or two after I filled it, they wouldn't, you know, the flame was too weak and small, and I was like, well, anyway, I let it aside for, I don't know, since May last year. As of today, it's January 21st. And yeah, I noticed that if I manually, you know, pressure valve, it would go a little bit further down. So I thought maybe if I can, on the cap here, there's a little, like, kind of a button, has a spring. If I open the spring, or maybe use a spacer to get it, to make it go down maybe half a millimeter or so, it'll help to close the valve and avoid the leakage. So I'll try to fix it while I enjoy my pipe. and see how it goes. So yeah, catch you in a while. Here's a little spring. And a little cap. Luckily me, my wife, she likes to do scrapbooking and handcrafts. She has this hole puncher. And the size of a hole is basically the same diameter of the where the little spacer goes in. So I'm going to use a little bit of paper, yeah, from the residues of the punch. I'm going to use the fills of the holes, if you will. See what happens. Hopefully it will work. Amazingly, it's the same diameter. Yeah, I need to magnify. For whatever reasons, you know, things, as you grow older, things tend to get smaller. I don't know why. Well, Operation Spacer has been completed. Will it be a success? Only time will tell. I think I forgot to mention on the earlier recordings. You can see the valve here, this one. There, that's where the butane comes out of, and that's where the flame throws. So what I did there is that I put a mark. Maybe you can see it. There's a vertical line there. Can't see it. Right about there. Before I put the spacer, if you closed it, that's where I put the mark, when it was closed before the spacer. And I noticed that if I press it manually, that little line there would go down further. So now with the spacer, when I close the cap, I cannot see the line, which I'm hoping it'll work. It was a little bit of a hassle to get that little cap out there, and then the spring flew. Had to find it. Fortunately, it was here. I have a tray here. It landed here on the tray. I started looking on the ground first, but then I noticed it was right here in the corner, right, I don't know, right in front of my eyes. yeah, put the spacer. Fortunately, the hole puncher, the hole is basically the same diameter of that little hole there in the cap, in here, right there. Let's see what happens. I'm going to refill the lighter because I had it open for quite a while. It leaked, obviously. When you have the cap open, butane comes out. Yeah, again, the time will tell. And one thing that I was able to help me identify with the needle, and I put dish soap. I put a drop or two on the valve, and it would do a little bit of slow bubbles. It's not doing it right now. I mean, it would take probably 10-15 minutes for the bubble to start getting noticed, because the leakage is way, way, way too small, too slow. But you know, enough for if you leave it sitting there on your counter or on your drawer. Or if you have it in your pocket with the body heat and movement, I guess that would accelerate the leakage. And you know, the great thing about it is that stuff that you can do over a pipe. That sounds like a familiar YouTube channel, doesn't it? Over a pipe. Cheers to our fellow piper, Martin, and his channel, Over a Pipe. Ha. Yeah, things that you can do over a pipe. That's nice. I also had to move a little bit because the sun was hitting me, as you can see the rays here. It was hitting me on my face real hard. Anyway, continue enjoying this beautiful Saturday morning, checking emails, and let's see what else we can fix over a pipe. My dear fellow piper, I thank you for sharing this video with me. Until the next one, happy smokes, God bless, cheers.